some kind if you guys really want me to.
Yeah, absolutely.
And next time we'll make it a 4-hour. Usually my lectures last about 4 hours, and I'll do a workshop the next day, which is a little easier to take care of things. But because of my schedule this time, it was just a little impossible. Because of our time sequence, we have to get out of here at a certain time, or approximately, más o menos. Approximately 11 seconds.
Time is only an illusion.
Yeah, time. Everything is an illusion. Remember when he was talking about it? You're an illusion, you're a hologram. Now, some people said I better stand clear up here because they want to see me. Is that better?
Yeah.
Yes? Okay, I'll do that. Because of the timing that we are squared away with this time, like I say, if you all want me to come back again sometime, I'll be glad to come back. You just have to arrange it with your group. I'm really here to have you guys get the handbook, Embracing the Rainbow and Becoming. What I want you to do is get together with the groups that are already meeting. And by the way, they're meeting all over the planet right now. I've never seen anything, even in Tibet.
Wow.
I was totally blown away. 20 sets went to Tibet. And they're in Russia. First time I ever got a Western Union for money out of Russia.
Nobody gets money out of Russia.
I did.
Yeah, that's pretty awesome.
Well, there's money over there. I'll give you, this is a besides the point thing. You guys know what city has more billionaires than any other city in the whole world?
Moscow.
Did you know that?
No.
Everything's an illusion that you hear. It's all out here. What they had it's all over the old wealth, obviously, and Russia is extremely wealthy with all kinds of things. The problem is that their climate, or if you look at it, it's like the Canadian area and above. My son spent a lot of time in the secret city on their nuclear technology, and we were discussing that. But right now, I think for the balance of the time, I'm going to do two things. I'm going to try to give you guys a direction to go in the days ahead. Because the extraterrestrials told me long time ago, when I started publishing all the bad things about what's going on the planet, their answer to me says, what good has that done? And I'm seriously. One of the things is you have to be aware of it. Don't put your head in the sand and say it's not going to affect you, because it's affecting all of us, me too. All of us are together. And I love you all, seriously, because you're all together. We're all together. I want you to all consider it's all a big bubble. And we're all bubbling together at this minute. And I'll tell you how fantastic it works. Hold on 1 second.
I'm going to do something. I want all of you to put your hands up. Just like this. Face them towards me. And what I'm going to do is I have an ability to call on the energies to go through me so each one of you feel part of me. All of you, the entire room. Do you feel it in the back? Small tingles, a little warmth. Do you feel that? We are all one. Let me give you some, that's okay, I'm gonna cut it down now.
It means what I do is affecting everything that you're doing. Everything that you do is affecting somebody else someplace else. And the four rules that are spelled out in the handbook are the way you're supposed to live the rest of your life. In other words, if you take the first law, which is the law of attraction, what you put out, you're going to get back. You have to look at thought. Remember in the Bible, whichever version you had in John 1, where it says, in the beginning there was the Word, and the Word was, you remember that?
Yeah.
Let's change one word. Is it okay?
Mm-hmm.
In the beginning it was thought. Aren't words thought out loud? When you pray, aren't you putting out thought? When you meditate, aren't you hoping to receive thought? Who I'm involved in, who actually is the author of these books, people have asked me, is at the thought at the creational level of not only of this universe, but others. We are so out of balance of this planet, I feel humbled that I've been given the job to act as a publisher for the extraterrestrials at the conscious level to awaken those that will awaken And every one of you have thought. Every one of you can manifest. It's a question of awakening to the knowledge to do that. Remember when Christ made 1,000 loaves out of bread? What did he do? He took a dozen, he visualized, and he created them by calling on the creation, just like I just got you doing with you guys, putting forth the energy to know that you have it. I'm able to balance energies. I've learned how to do that. So if somebody is sick or something, I learned how to do that. I can usually bring you back. The problem is, how did you cause it in the first place? And most things will go back to where you started. So I may give you an instantaneous relief or something else, or headaches or whatever you're talking about, just by using the energies. And I don't touch you. I just use my energies to balance you. The problem is the staying in balance in the first place, because that's what's going on. We have to find out. Remember that little book I showed you a while ago, Your Body Knows Best? Because you can find out what is necessary to cure yourself naturally. You can know what's necessary to make the decisions that you need to do in the days ahead, and we need all the help we can do and have. The next thing I want to talk about is, obviously, where do you want to live? And I'm not a traffic cop, so I can't tell you. When you get together with your groups, you want to start figuring out the logical progression of where. There's no place that's going to be safe on the planet. I mean, some places are going to be safer than others. I was kind of directed. I had about four or five places where I could have went. I just decided where I wanted to go, which was in Idaho, and I don't want you all to show up in Idaho, but the thing that happened is that the most valuable mineral on the planet is water. Water is an interesting situation. Do you realize that water, as we drink it, and we've had some people in here talking about using thought and crystallizing water? But if you take water and freeze it, it expands and it'll break a bottle, right? But if I heat it up, it also expands and breaks in the bottle. It's still the same water. Where are we getting all this energy? I'm just telling you, we have a lot of things. The most, people have heard of Germain supposedly be the alchemist who's given us information on frequency and condensing. You know the best alchemist that we have running around the streets right now? Common Cow. Common Cow goes out, eats green grass, right? And gives white milk loaded with calcium. Where do they get the calcium? There's none in the grass. These are just some things to look at. People in here, have you heard of colloidal silver?
Yes.
I have a real problem with colloidal silver. I'm going to give you a real quick chemistry lesson. Colloidal silver is basically silver that's in a solution that is used to basically cut down bacteria, etc. But when you have colloidal silver, you put it on a wound or something, and it'll automatically cure a lot of things. Back during World War I and World War II, when a soldier got shot, they would put a silver coin over it, and the body would create a level, and it'd heal it up. A friend of mine, a doctor down in South Carolina, started developing. He's world famous over here for orthopedic surgery, taking off people's legs and everything else because of all the things happening. And he found out that if he took silver and put it into a bandage and wrapped around the bandage, that the body would become whole again and he didn't have to cut it off. It's called Silveron bandages. They are available. I used to have them available to show you, but the FDA stepped in and said a bandage has to be prescribed by a doctor. But it is available. Now, let me tell you what my problem is with colloidal silver from a chemistry standpoint. Colloidal silver is pure solution silver, and I've done tests on it, and if you put it into the water, it starts breaking down about 20% a day. So that means you better, in other words, it's losing its being in suspension for that period. If I drink this colloidal silver, what's the first thing that happens? It obviously hits your mouth, which is okay, but it gets your stomach. What acid is in your stomach? Hydrochloric acid, right? Well, chemistry-wise, if I take HCl and add that to Ag, which is a chemical formula for silver, it immediately converts to HgCl, silver chloride, which is a base, which means it's not going anywhere. So we've lost all of the momentum on it. That's what I'm telling you. However, what you think happens. So what we come back to is, since everything is a product of the thought, let's do it that way. Okay, the next thing we want to discuss is the monetary situation. The New World Order's money situation is this. There's going to be two types of money. One of them is the plastic card, like I showed some of you people out there already. It's right here. It says, convenient, secure, global cash. I was with the president of the company. He was flying down to Dallas when we were discussing this. They just printed $500 million on them. That's extras. They're doing them all over the globe, by the way. They're getting this thing set up for, it says global cash. It doesn't say dollars. It says cash. What they're going to be doing is, if you have the illusion of cash in the bank, it's gone. If you think you have real estate, you don't own it either. All real estate in the United States is held by what we call the regular title policy, and it's all subject to taxes paying to the state. If you don't pay taxes to the state, the state will take your property and sell it to somebody else. Yeah. So indirectly, what you have is constructive right to use the airspace subject to keeping it up and paying the taxes, right? So you're doing this for the government, which is who? It's not all of us like it used to be. It's a small group of people that are telling you what you're doing. So real estate, and even though I was a big developer, I've gotten rid of all my real estate that I have in the world, except for I still own a couple of pieces of property in Costa Rica. And I'm almost entirely in gold and silver and not stocks. Now let's talk about stocks for a minute. I was a financial principal and an underwriter of stocks. That's the biggest con game going on the planet right now. The stock market is nothing more than a bunch of people playing with a bunch of pieces of paper out here, a big monopoly game with nothing behind it. The stockbrokers make a business of trying to convince you to buy this stock that's going to go up, but who? They don't own the stock. They get a commission every time they sell it. But who do they buy the stock from? Some other stockbroker. And or a mutual fund. Mutual funds are nothing more than another stock that owns a bunch of stocks. It has no voting rights. A mutual fund has a custodian bank that's holding the money, and we have a mutual fund manager that manages supposedly a portfolio of stocks. Okay? I'm going to give you some understanding here. The average age of a mutual fund manager is about age 30. There are more mutual funds than there are stocks on the stock exchange. Mutual fund manager only gets his bonuses by what? Getting together with meetings behind somebody else and convincing you this is the latest thing to go. The problem is that most companies, there's a few exceptions, don't pay out dividends, don't pay anything because they don't have to. The companies themselves have the ability themselves to keep all the money once we've issued the stock, and I'm an underwriter. As once I've issued the stock to the public and I got all my rest of my brokers to share in it, we gave you what we call an IPO, and basically initial public offering, then you are hoping it's going to run up. It's kind of like what they just got you doing to a couple cool. stocks on the...
Yeah.
At any rate, what we're looking at is all you're doing is trading between each other, guys. Your odds are better off in Vegas. It really is true. Now, the situation is this piece of paper represents absolutely nothing other than maybe an undivided interest in 1/1000th of whatever's left, but you don't even know what the accounting rules are. Are you familiar with the term GSE? That's government-sponsored enterprises. Government-sponsored enterprise. Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac. Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac are not government agencies. They were sponsored originally in order to provide money for the housing, remember? They hold right now approximately a little over $6 trillion of mortgages. They have no assets. Their asset base that they're using on their deal are derivatives. For all of you, are there any accountants here in this room? If there was, I'd like them to give me a definition of how they can determine the value of a derivative. A derivative has no, it's an arbitrary figure. They just arbitrarily created it out of thin air. And how they get to it is, let's give you an illustration. I showed some of you people that I have a piece of gold in my pocket. Well, here's a piece of silver. Okay, I actually have physical silver in my pocket. If I agreed to sell this silver to you in December at $8, and I still have it, what you have is a derivative. You don't own the silver, but you have a right to buy. Now what if you sold that derivative to this other guy over here for $10? In other words, your right to buy mine, you sold it to somebody else. What do we have? The backing of the major banks in New York right now, $100 trillion worth, are derivatives. What we have is a huge Ponzi game that is planned to collapse. So if you have any money, get it out of the market, and the timing was yesterday. We run out of time. Get gold and silver. I don't care where you get it. Go on the internet, look around. I mean, I get it for some of my friends if they wanted to. You want to get what you can have is easily identified. Forget about what we call numismatics. Numismatics were collector's pieces that they didn't take care of the last time. Now, in the accounting book, I was concerned about that. So when I looked up the accounting, the New World, it's called Systems of National Accounting. You can get a copy yourself. It's $100 and you get it from the World Bank. It's about this thick and it's about a telephone book. Most people wouldn't understand it, and I was only interested in four pages. A, the definition of money, and the definition of gold. And the definition of gold, as I said, was commodity gold and monetized gold. Gold that is held in your pocket, that's in the ground or anything else, is called commodity gold. It really doesn't have a value. Monetized gold is only gold held by the central bank, whatever is going to be left, or under their direct control. So if you and I have gold, and there, by the way, it's really getting hard for me to get it. I just tried to pick up 100 pieces from a friend of mine the other day. I got them, but it took me about 4 days. I'm buying maple leaves because I'm trying to get you gold as close as we can to spot. Every day they trade it. You mentioned a few minutes ago about the Rothschilds. The Rothschilds were interesting because the Rothschilds were the biggest traders in gold in London for the last 40 years. They don't want it, so they shut down their gold trading. Within a week, our great illustrious leader over in England, his over there, said they were going to have a referendum on changing their currency now to the euro. Euro is partially backed by gold. Right now, you got Putin that told Bush no more dollars for gold, for the oil. That's what they're doing. They're selling their oil right now for gold. Or Malaysian currency. Malaysians are turning together gold at this minute. Historically, that's what it's going to do. The most valuable thing that's going to be in the future? Not necessarily. Food. In 3 days, people will steal for food. In a week, they'll kill for it. When I was at the Population Institute on this last, 3 days ago, I'm sitting there looking at pictures of little kids over in Africa. They're actually out picking up ants for their food. Little baby ants. I don't know if you've seen these or not. I mean, I'm sitting here looking, they don't have any food. They're nothing left of these things. And yet we're looking, and I have a doctor friend that was very concerned about this stuff, and he said, look, I can help, because we mine 90% of the fish in the ocean. Did you know that? Mining means we processed almost all the edible fish that are there today. And this doctor friend of mine said, that's a concern to me. How do we help these people in Africa? So he got a $100,000 grant from the World Health Organization on working on DNA, that's to change the fish so it would be edible. Man, that's a good plan, wasn't it? Part of this program was that he had to share the technology with the doctors at Fort Detrick, Maryland. Fort Detrick, Maryland said, aha, we have some new information now, so we're going to create this new thing for this population control stuff. And so there's where they created a new virus that we all commonly call AIDS. Nobody dies of AIDS, never have. What you do is you die of opportunistic infections because the AIDS shuts down your immune system. What you need to do is learn nutrition, because nutrition is what keeps your body going. So that's real critical. I want you to start thinking about as many natural foods as you can. The organic grown, if you can. Most of the other foods, and organic's kind of a misnomer, even though they claim organic, it's not necessarily true. And in California, they have a real big deal. Notice when you go to the grocery store, they have a big deal about carrots. Don't you buy the carrots coming in from California? Carrots are planted between the crops of cotton. Did you know that? It's in between to bring the soil back, and what to do, the carrots take all the junk and stuff we sprayed on the cotton plants and absorbed it back into it. So when you're making your carrot juice, what are you getting?
Poison.
You're getting poisoned whether you know it or not, and it's very slowly. I'm just telling you that an educational bet that you want to look at is food and nutrition is very critical. Start looking at all the alternative. There's a lot of my doctor friends are getting out of the doctor friend business because of all of basically the HMOs and the insurance companies, which really control the medical industry and the pharmaceutical companies. They're all manipulated the same. They're all run by the same house of cards that are sitting down here and using you as basically experiments. And I'll tell you how bad the experiment is. World War II, which is a ways back, the doctor that was in charge of doing all the experiments on how to kill people in Manchuria, up in China, he was a Japanese soldier. Remember how the Japanese were taking our prisoners? They take them up and they were injecting them with everything they could to figure out what to do. At the end of World War II, we gave him citizenship, and he's in charge of Fort Detrick, Maryland. Pretty heavy? So what we have is a stacked deck, no matter which one. But if you're smart and you're one of those guys, aren't you going to hire the best talent to run anything? That's the same thing with them. So they want you to get the best education. They're going to call you out. You can't even get your kid into high or college right now because of the grade score. Everybody's going at it. And right now, remember what I told you? You were a human resource. If you were an engineer today and you were looking at the bottom line, where would you get the best trained engineers for the lowest cost in the world? India. Mm-hmm. And China. So what does that do to the Americans? We basically got rid of everything here, guys. The United States is on the way out and very fast right now. So my critical thing is, I want you guys to consider, and just consider what I'm saying. Research what I'm telling you. Is get rid of your real estate. It's a burden on you. You think you own the house, it owns you. Things will become a very big burden in the days ahead because you're not going to take anything with you. And you're not even real. Remember? You're an illusion, you're a hologram of condensed. Remember that picture of the spacecraft coming down? Now, I used him as an experiment a little while ago, didn't I? And we just showed what happened on that. Let me show them things that are even worse. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
He's a real good kid. No, come on up. I just want to show you this. We're going to do the same little deal I had. Stand up.
I'm just going to prove that he's a hologram. Hold your arm out. Now, I'm going to push down on this hologram, right? Okay. I'm pushing down. He's holding it up. Now, what I'm going to do now is cut the outer energy lines by doing this, which I just did. Now watch. Did you see that? So what I'm telling you is you are a hologram of condensed light. You can only visually see what's going on. How many of you in here have seen the new movie, What the Flow?
What the Bleep?
Yeah, What the Bleep.
From a scientific standpoint, when you come down to the smallest particles, you look at it, and it's in the movie. It appears that the smallest particles is a series of protons and neutrons that are spinning so fast they appear to be solid. So what happens is, you appear to be solid. The truth is, I was easily manipulating you without touching you. And I do the same thing when I was talking about doing energy work. I pull the energy around your body. I have the ability to feel the energy and see what's going on within your body. Since you're all being held together and you didn't know you were just an illusion, inside of us is a spirit. The trouble is we don't awaken to that spirit within. I want all of you to try to awaken to be in constant communion with spirit. The lessons are in the handbook, Embracing Rainbow and Becoming. I suggest you all get in there, and everything you do from now on, what I do, is for the highest and best good for mankind. It's not for how much I can put in my pocket. It's how much we can do to have a segment of the reality that's going to be left on this planet. I'm going to read you the final message that I got. I mean, it's not the final one I got, but I'm going to read you a message I got from the extraterrestrials. And this is, remember, everything, somebody asked me something about, well, I did this 20 years ago. Guys, it's okay to look back. Don't stare. only thing that's existing is right now. And what we're going to create in the future, is that okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's all we're going to do. And it's all done by what? Thought. In connection with the creation, in order to sustain an extension of the creation, otherwise we're going to cease to exist as we know it. Let me get this little message for you.
Plane tickets.
No, my two extra tickets.
Right.
I got three tickets to come down here today because my plane was a little mechanical problems. And so I didn't make sure I was coming here. I got the next two flights booked.
Oh,
and I got the tickets to prove it.
It's parallel.
What I want to do is I'm going to read this to you. And then when I get through reading this, then I'm going to open it up for a little while for questions on any subject, because I went over a lot of it, and like I say, we run out of time too quick. And it's too important, so you probably want me back, and when we can reschedule, we have a lot more time without an ending of the story. Is that all right? This is the last message that I got that makes any sense. In the days to be experienced by humanity as time winds down, it is necessary that those of you who are now in the know, so to speak, that you guys, begin to focus on what might be called holding the pole, holding the fort. As the chaos increases, it is important that there be those that keep their focus and balance as the meltdown begins in earnest. In other words, all of you are going to have to sit back and say, hey, this is a big play. Though it appears that all is lost, it's the steadfastness of the few that will determine just how much chaos and suffering will be experienced. While it seems that little use in doing this, I can assure you that it's critical that those who can do it. Inasmuch as there are now many of you who now know what is happening and also understand that the extent of the chaos will reach extreme proportions. As the general population of this country finally get the picture, it's an imperative that we have this service rendered. In other words, it's going to be hard for you to stay in an observer role. That's part of the plan, you know, part of the lessons you're going to learn. Exactly what does it mean? It means that these people must hold a vision of a connection to the Creator. It's not even necessary that they know that a plan or a firm and absolute knowingness that a plan exists, but I assure you that it does. No matter how difficult the circumstance, the plan of Creator will come into being. It probably will not happen in ways that were previously conceived by those working on it through these many generations, but it positively will happen. While time in the third dimension continues to pass day by day, in dimensions where there is no time, think about that, no time, only clarity of experience, it's difficult for those on each side of these diametrically different views to communicate. Remember what I told you, that we have all this radiation by all kinds of ELF and everything else? To keep you from being in contact yourselves. I want everybody in here to be in contact like I am. Is that okay? Ask. A little prayer. Remember, I am a human becoming. Help me become. Gives them permission to communicate with all of you. Each tries to estimate the possibilities the other is considering and experiencing. In other words, both sides are trying to figure out. Like when I go with the CIA, they keep me alive. They want to know what's going on the other side. This muddies the picture on both sides. The greater problem is the fact that those who oppose the Creator's plan are extremely well organized on the time-oriented side, while the organization of the Creator's plan is on the other side of the timeline. Meanwhile, the masses of humanity are lacking any organization. We're not, are we? Aren't we getting organized with the handbook and the paradigm groups? We're working on it. Meanwhile, again, this are currently mesmerized in a declining mental and physical condition, because that's what you're doing. You're getting bombarded by everything and food and the whole works. To say the least, this creates what appears to be a lopsided picture. The balancing feature is the fact that humanity is both consciously and unconsciously asking for help. The help that's available does not appear in a tangible way that humanity as a whole can recognize, and yet it is definitely present and available. In other words, the energies that I just got you demonstrating to you, obviously, I'm putting them out there, they're available. Creation wants you to have all. Creation doesn't want it set down to destroy something. This is a huge manifestation on planet Earth of the creation contemplating what it is, and you're an extension of that creation. We're all connected. Humanity wants to know the exact time they were going to be rescued. Impossible dream. I made an exception, this isn't on here, I'm going to share something with you. When I was in Australia, in the outback, I was out in the middle, I was with a few of my other friends, and we were out in the middle of nowhere. If you've been to the outback, that's exactly what it is. Out of nowhere came an Aborigine. He came up to me and he said, "What are you doing down here?" And I said, I was curious what the outback was about. And he says, "Are you sure?" He says, "Are you a missionary?" And I said, "Nope, not." He says, "Oh, good." And he says, he turned around and he says, "Look up there." And I said, "Look where?" And the sun was going. He said, "See that?" He said, "That's my God." He says, "I can live without your God. You can't live without mine." The Aborigines are the remnants of the last time around that we've gone through this cycle. They have asked for it and given permission not to reincarnate at this time. Because this effort that we're going to go through right now is not part of their journey. So they're no longer having children. And they're not going to reincarnate on this planet. But check it out. Interesting, huh? The other thing, a lot of extraterrestrial people will say, "We're in contact with ETs, they're going to lift us off." The extraterrestrials say, "Now think about that. Remember, the universe is logical. We would trash another planet in half the time." We really would.
Less.
Less time, yeah. It says, "Many estimates have been supposedly received through psychic receiver more by personal desire than actual heavenly estimates. In this reality, it's a matter of sequential events that must take place, rather like pieces of a jigsaw puzzle, that first must fit before certain other events can then take place. Frustratingly for those focused on this situation from the no-time side, many of these jigsaw pieces must be put in place by those humans now who are more handicapped than ever, thus slowing down the timeline. Too many people that I talk to choose to go back to sleep." Responsibility. Everybody understand the word responsibility? It's two words. Responsibility and the ability to respond. Once I awaken you up, now you got the responsibility to carry the torch or spin on the information. Because what we need to do is spread this like fire all over the planet to change the ending of the story that's been written for us. And that's what I'm here for. Is to try to give you the knowledge enough so you can get an idea of what the bad guys are doing, but also the impetus so you get up and change the ending of the story. That's what it's all about. Thus, the message of encouragement to those who are aware and capable of understanding the nature of their assignment is to hold the pole. Again, hold the fort. That's all I want you to do. Get knowledgeable. They must know that there's a plan and they're very much part of this plan, even though their part appears to be doing nothing. That's going to be hard. Ego says, "I'm doing something." In fact, it's important that they appear to be doing nothing as to not to draw undue attention to yourselves. So when you get the handbook, it says get together with groups of 3, 7, 11. It gives you all the instructions. That's the key, and then spin off and keep doing it. Now, I have some friends, well, you probably saw it, that have group meetings of 100 or more, and some of you do it. And I don't have any problem with all of that. But ask guidance within your groups. Because I'm not sitting here. These are all suggestions to us. What's the wild card in the universe? Free will. You have the ability to say, "Hey, George, I don't believe anything." I want you all to go check out what I have to say. I want you to discern it. I don't even care if you don't believe it. I showed you enough information to make at least ponder some of it may be correct, right? And nothing to gain other than the planet. I wouldn't be doing this unless I figured, frankly, if I don't do it, we don't have a planet left. That's how much responsibility I feel. I feel like Johnny Appleseed. I'm planting seeds all over the crazy world right now. Mm-hmm. I'm just hoping they're going to start germinating. But I know and I'm recognizing they probably won't germinate until the chaos starts in earnest. Because people will prefer to go back to sleep. And you're going to find that out. They won't listen to you. A lot of people won't be able to read this book. Some of you have read it once and said, I don't understand this. And then all of a sudden, the second time, everything become crystal clear. Remember the FedEx sign? Once you are awakened to what's going on, the programming that will happen to you in the creation, because you are an extension of the creation, we are going to change the ending of the story. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Can I have all your support? I'll give you this, it's kind of the personal, at the end of it, it says, those who are actively on the forefront know and understand their roles. That's kind of like I think I am. It is those who are quietly to do their part that need the most encouragement. It is important that each focus know their task and ask for guidance, provision, and protection daily. I want all of you to do that. That's what you want to, and make yourself, it's not riches, abundance. In other words, the food and necessary things to need that you have to maintain yourself in the days ahead for you and your family, because that's very critical. Life begins at conception. You actually pick your parents. Life, from a physical standpoint, from a very scientific standpoint, if thought was going out here, and I'm just going to give you a real quick lesson in mechanics of thought, if I put out a plus one, don't you think I'm putting out an energy? Don't we have to have an equal and opposite? A minus one. If I double the thought, plus two, minus two, and so on, we really have the periodic table of elements. So everything I thought I learned at Mines and chemistry and all the rest of it about the atomic theory is not true. What it is light vibrating at different patterns. And there are books available, back in our catalog. We have one, it's called Secrets of Light, and it was done by Germain through the Walter Russell Group down in University of Science in Swannanoa, Virginia. They've given us a lot of answers, and we have to look at it, and we want to definitively look at it. Again, I don't know if it's going to make any difference. Time's running out. There's abundant groups of people that are working on energy devices like I showed you, a little free motor that's in my pocket, and other things that are happening, so those who will come together of like minds will be given the technology. Once we come into balance, we can then, working with the creation, clean up this planet. And the extraterrestrials said that they would be glad to come down and help clean up the planet once we come into balance. Are we in balance on this planet?
No.
It's not going to happen tomorrow. I am concerned because the bad guys and my information from the extraterrestrials that say things are getting critical right now and beginning this next year. So get yourself prepared for next year. And I'll be glad to come back again sometime next year. If we can do it.
When we can do it.
Well, the problem is that I'm getting information from guys that travel will not be very safe here after the next few months. And I don't know exactly when. I've been given notification that to go get a passport right now. The guys in Washington are talking about taking passports away from people and giving you maybe a 2-year or a 3-year lease. So if you can, go renew your passports. They're good for 10 years. You can even take an old one and renew it. Where are you going to go? I don't know. The agreements they're making right now in Canada are very horrendous. We basically put out everybody. All of our kids are gone to, you know, fighting a no-good war someplace, all over money. And so what's happening is a lot of them... Did you know the day before the election, just to give you some illustrations of what's going on, this was in the papers. The day before the election in Canada, there was 13,000 applications for immigration to Canada?
Yeah.
Did you know that?
Yeah, yeah.
How many was the day after?
More.
130,000.
Wow.
Everybody's looking to go someplace else. One of my good friends, an astronaut, Apollo astronaut, I just gave him a bunch of gold and he head off to Ecuador. Brian O'Leary. Interesting? Again, I always thought Costa Rica was going to be good. Frankly, Costa Rica is very expensive. I'm kind of in because my friends down there were the government leaders. Costa Rica is all CIA, just so you know. It's just as most of the countries are. There are other places, but there are safe places here in the United States. So that you're going to have to consider. Each one of you are going to have to think about what you're going to do. I would suggest getting food stored up. I would suggest getting water, purifiers. I would suggest getting any kind of grains that you can have to keep around, even the ones that you sit down and grow, You can figure out, there's a little book that I have in our catalog, and it's called Patriots. A guy in Idaho put that thing together. He has done a marvelous job of putting everything you needed to go together to have yourself in a survival mode in order to continue on. It's not outlandish, but it's information in the catalog. And you all have catalogs that are out there on the desk if you have one. Or give us a call. I am available on I'm actually available. I answer the phone a lot of times at my office. I have other people that do it. Because when I come into town, I'm enjoying talking to you because you all have individual questions and answers at that. Okay, at this minute, let me open it up for any general questions, and I'll try to be very specific and give you some quick answers while we have a chance. Yes?
Where do we put our money if it's not in the bank?
The question is, where do you put your money if not in the bank? Other than gold and silver. Well, first of all, dollars are going to go away. I suggest you have some dollars. I maintain some. I have them hidden. I just carry the cash. I don't want to have any access. I'll shut the banks down. One of the banks that I know is going to be a surviving bank is a Rothschild bank. And which one is that?
Chase.
No,
that's Rockefeller.
Bank of Nova Scotia, Scotia Bank. It also happens to be a gold dealer. If you have a lot of money, there's a way to. I'll talk off the record and tell you how to do that. But. There's some way I know what their game is, so I know how I can protect you. You also want to make yourself basically a pauper if you can. If you got all kinds of money, I can tell you how you can put the money out and have it hidden and have 100% control of the money. No trust, no none of that out. But you have access to it, which will be available to you in the days ahead.
In this country?
In this country. There's only one place left to do that. Under the new Patriot Act, all money that is put offshore, all money put offshore in any capacity, whether it's a trust, corporation, or any capacity there, must be reported back to the U.S. government. All foreign institutions, all banks, everywhere, if they have a deposit and an American's on the name, they have to report it back to the U.S. Treasury. If you do not report it, they consider it either drug-related or terrorist-related, and they're taking the money. I have a friend of mine that put about several $1 million in Switzerland several years ago, 20 years ago. And he just had $450,000 wired back at Chemical Bank, and the State Department stopped the money. Now, this was 20 years ago money. They demanded that he show where he got the money from 20 years ago, or they were going to confiscate it. We worked it out. I got the money taken care of through the way I've done it, so he has the money today. But you're going to have to learn to be very smart in the days ahead in order to do that. The key is, and do you take the lessons that they do. The lesson, when I was in Washington, I was over on Washington Street, just so you know, that's where the Population Institute of the World, and they keep track of everything. Remember, I have a little flyer outside, take one with you, give you some of the books. I want you to get the book State of the World, for the new one, 2005. You can buy it from them. I'm going to put it in my catalog, but it's not out for another month. It will tell you the condition of everything that's going on the planet, so you can at least have a guide, nothing what I'm talking about. Then the next thing you want to consider is, if that is, how do I get the money so I have control of it? I'll give you a little secret. You create a new individual. How do you create a new individual? A corporation, by definition, is a new individual. Now, I want to create an individual where I don't have to report to the government. Where can I do that? Only one state left.
Nevada.
You create a corporation in the state of Nevada which has no income tax. All money is held in the hands of this corporation. Only needs one officer. You are it. You have that bank open up a bank account in the Bank of Nova Scotia. All money goes in there, and you don't care what the hell happens to ours. However, if it's in dollar denominations, you may not have anything. Then my deal is, have the Bank of Nova Scotia, and I'm going to give you what I figured out. Have the Bank of Nova Scotia buy $100,000 of the gold, borrow against the gold. They have the asset. They've already monetized it, right? Then you can do whatever you want to with it. These are the things, of the tricks of the trade that you can play with. Remember, all the crooks, and that's where they do all their stuff, is in Nevada anyway. Nevada is divided up into two sections. The southern part of Nevada is controlled by the mafia out of Florida. The northern section is controlled by the mafia out of New York. Reno. Did you know that? It's all an intersection. When you go down there and see Phil Wynn or Steve Wynn's new castle up there, Steve Wynn's not in the mafia. His wife happens to be the daughter of the head of the mafia. Does that fit together the pieces for you?
Yeah.
Everything is manipulated in every state down to Schwarzenegger in California. Do you think Schwarzenegger in California is any different off? California, we know, is going into the ocean. I mean, I saw pictures of San Francisco totally destroyed. I own a shopping center in Robertson, that's in Beverly Hills in California. Remember that big one happened? Whole I-10 collapsed and everything else. I got rid of that too. I mean, everything, even Beverly Hills, every other building is for rent. The economy is really starting to collapse in a lot of different directions. Gasoline and oil, we don't have enough supply. Expect gasoline to be $3 a gallon within the next couple of months. Now, what it does, at $2 a gallon, and this is a survey that was done by our friends at Walmart, they determined it took $130 a month out of the typical spending plan of a family to buying goods at $2. At $3, in California right now, I was just at Beverly Hills, well, I'm in LAX, gasoline is $2.95 a gallon at the airport. At the airport. You can get away from it and get it down to $2.50. But I'm just giving you an idea of what's happening on it. And people out there are already going down to single cars and their joint with their families to go to places and start looking at it. Cars are going to be almost a detriment for you. Transportation and getting things, that's what I'm saying. Start getting things prepared. Preparation is key. Yes?
Could you speak briefly about 911? I mean, and what you see for the foreseeable future of another event like this?
Before I came here tonight, I was talking to people. Did anybody see my videos outside, the one that I had on 9/11? They're $10 a piece. For an hour and a half, you get to see exactly how they were taken down. However, I just got this when I was in Washington. Anybody remember a guy by the name of Dole? Robert Dole? You do remember him? Did you know his chief of staff by the name of Stanley Hilton?
Yeah.
Stanley Hilton was his chief of staff, and he come forth and he has direct connections now to Cheney, was given orders to take the building down.
Hilton?
Stanley Hilton.
He's the guy who's got an $8 billion lawsuit against.
Stanley.
Stanley.
Well, whatever. He was his chief of staff. Well, he got the same one, I'm not sure.
Yeah, same one. He's a lawyer.
Well, he's got the documents to show that Cheney and all. You know, let me tell you what the problem is, because I run around with these guys. When we were planning on reducing the world's population, I mean, I sat in on these meetings. There was like a dozen of us. I would leave with maybe five of the other people, and we'd go into the room, and they would be talking about getting rid of some of the ones that we just left. So it was like being in a den of rattlesnakes, scorpions, you understand, and black widows, each one of them capable of killing each other. And who's going to be on top at the end? You are. Because what they created, they can only control the physical dimension. We want you to come to the position, understanding that you're a spirit, the spirit that you have within, and that you can call on the creation, and we're going to try to give you the tools so you're going to be in that position as an active part of changing the end of the story. With that, they're going to throw me out of here. Look, they open up the doors. I want to thank you all for coming. And I guess you have a message that you want to give. Are you giving away Christmas presents he's giving away?
Let's give a big hand to George.
No, what I'm going to show is there's a book that's in my catalog, and it's called Your Body Knows Best. You guys, if you really get the book and study it, you're going to learn all kinds of things, because your spirit's going to come through and try to tell you
what's really happened because we have been programmed so much. It's like this gentleman here thinks he's really solid and he's really there. You're not. Hold your arm up. We want to see how strong he is. Now I'm going to push down on this. I thought, okay, you're familiar with kinesiology, right? Well, I'm not going to hypnotize you. I'm just telling you. You know that? Okay. Oh, have you? Well, that's okay. I want you to do this. Don't look. Give me your other hand. No, put it down. I just want you to put this in your hand. Squeeze. Now put your arm up. Put this one. Yeah. Now I'm going to push down. Ready? Yeah, I did it real easy, right? Guess what? Equal in aspartame. What is, and he didn't know it. It made him go, now I'm going to add more fun. You're not done yet. We're going to go to the next step. The next step is, I told you that he was a hologram. Put your arm out again. He's strong, right? I'm pushing down. Push down. Ready? Okay, now watch this. No, keep your arm out there. I want to show these people. Ready? Okay.
Did you see what I did?
Everybody see that? What happens is I... Don't look amazed. We're not through. What happens is you're a hologram of condensed light. So obviously we have visible light and invisible. The energy field on the outside of you is easily manipulated. I made you weak without touching you. Shall we do it again without touching you? Only I want the audience to do it. Okay? What I'm going to do is you put your arm out, and what... Don't look at me, look at them. I want them just to mentally think. Ready for this? Make him weak. Just think. Get weak. Now, let's reverse it. Put your arm out again. I want all of you telling him to get strong. You ready? Get strong. How's that? Now, let's go. You can go ahead and sit down. So, if we can do that. They did it. What happened is I just cut your outer, your auric field, if you want to call it, your chi or your energy field. Did everybody see that? How easy was that being manipulated? You can do the same thing with fluorescent fixtures, and I didn't see any around here to do that because they'll make you weak also. Did you all learn something just then? Remember this thing? Okay, I'm going to go to the next step. What I want to do is open this up to some questions, because I go over a lot of material fairly fast because of this evening that we got a limited thing, and I'm going to answer whatever you want.
What if you're retired on Social Security and you have no money to speak with?
The question is, what if you're retired, you're on Social Security, and you have no money to speak with? You get with other friends of, like, because Social Security has no money either. All the money's been borrowed out of Social Security, as you know, or maybe you didn't know, and it's no longer going to be there. When this thing collapses, the plan is, well, I'll make it even more fun. When I was here, Barry will tell you, when we were here in Vegas, I got a contract to build an enemy prisoner of war camp in downtown Las Vegas. I gave it to Ted Gunderson, pardon? It's down by the railroad tracks. I gave it to Ted Gunderson, you guys, Ted lives here, he's a former, you know, FBI head, and Ted found out they're building them all over the United States. Enemy prisoner of war camp. Hey. You. And you. Yes, ma'am. 4.5 years ago. I put a copy of the contract in my book, Chaos in America. I think there's one over there. You can actually read it. See it? You can pull it up and it's in the back part. You can actually read it. And it says, enemy prisoner of war camp. Also, Bush, with his power, remember he playing a huge game? Ever hear of an executive order? It's not in the Constitution. Isn't that a dictator? Is there any? It's supposed to be checks and balances. Are there any checks and balances? Don't we have the best government money can buy? We no longer have it. Yes. Well, we're not all going to die. And what they're trying to do is, it's like releasing information prematurely. It's like when I brought, you guys all remember this, is, you've since you've been here 4 or 5 years, most of you, right?
48.
Well, let's say four or five.
Yeah, right.
The only reason is because I'm concerned about all this. I went to a lecture down in Atlanta, Georgia, and I'm one of these people that run around the planet. I was down in a lecture, and I'll fill in the blanks for you because it happened right here. When I was at Atlanta, I was listening to Larry Harris, who's a doctor of microbiology. And I was listening to Larry, and he's telling me, wait a minute, one of his students was an Iraqi woman. She said, her and a group brought over all the biological warfare in their vaginal cavities here in the United States, and they set up cells all over. Then I'm talking to Bill Levitt, who was over in Green Valley. He and a couple doctors were working on vibrational medicine using techniques to take the blood and then go through the purifier by using electromagnetics in order to get rid of the diseases. Anyway, I mentioned it to Bill Levitt about, I said, I just listened to this incredible thing, and I checked with my CIA buddy, and it's all true. Now, Bill Levitt, or Larry Harris, says anybody in the United States can get anthrax in the mail. So he ordered the anthrax, ordered it from a biological supply company, and the federal government come in and got him for getting it, but anybody could get it anyway. So he pled guilty. He was basically a parole. Pled guilty. I got it. It's a big deal. When I told it to Bill, Bill says, I can probably help cure this stuff. So he flew back to Ohio, brought Larry Harris here to Las Vegas. Bill Levitt and Larry Harris got together, and Ted Gunderson had a TV program. Remember Ted ran for president? Had a TV program, and they were going to bring it up and discuss this on a television program about the possibility of Las Vegas being a target for the biologicals because of the heavy turnover of people here, right? I mean, all it takes is 3 days, you wouldn't even know you had it, and we transplanted it all the way across the United States. Anyway, another gentleman right here in Las Vegas decided this is a big deal, and he brought in the FBI, and what happened? All the headlines in Las Vegas was, we've got biology or anthrax in Las Vegas, this is a big deal, and they crucified these two people. It was in all the papers. Poor Bill Levitt, who's a good Mormon bishop, they went to his house, he lived over by, closer to the Utah border, they come and stripped everything out of his house, put him in jail, strip searched him 3 times, I like that. He's blown away. He's working with doctors in Germany. He went to Germany and couldn't even get back in the United States. He's not here now. He is they consider him the most deadly guy there is, and all he was trying to do was help. Meanwhile, Larry Harris is back in Ohio right now. He's no longer on any of it. But it hit all the papers and hit the whole country. It was on television and everything else right here. You guys remember some of that, right? So unfortunately, I was indirectly responsible because I put the two together and brought them over here. I'm not bad. I'm not really good. By the way, I will tell you what Bill Levitt did, or Larry did tell me. And he said, simple, the easiest way to kill all these biology or bacteriological agents is for you guys to get some tetracycline. He says, it's a real killer for all of the ones that you have, but don't take it until you need it, because it'll burn you up. And how do you get to the tetracycline? You go to your local pet store,
right.
And you can get bottles, right?
For fish aquariums.
Yeah, for fish aquariums and everything else. And it is basically human-grade tetracycline.
You just take the capsule part.
Yeah.
You take the capsule.
That's right. Yes, ma'am. The question was, the specified data, how long are they effective? Don't believe anything anybody tells you in the industry, because they create the illusion that you got to replace something that may be good for 5 years because they make more money selling you the replacement. You start checking it out and you start asking people, how long is that? Is it food grade? What is it? Well, how long can we have it? How come animals do certain things? I used to cut up animals in my dad's packing house, so I got to see all these diseases and everything. And what we did, what is a disease? Dis-ease? We're out of vibration? So when we look at it, how do we cure all these things? We have to do the curing. All of us are nothing more than a member of this spirit having a physical experience, except for our bodies being bombarded from everything and all foods, and even the energy of people around you. If you read the first part of the handbook, it'll tell you that there'll be a lot of splitting in energies, because as you wake up, you, for some reason, you're going to get so awake, you won't be able to tolerate having some people around here because they're so negative. You're going to have to sit in the observer mode of this huge play again that's being played. Now let's add more fun. This is just the beginning of the play. Because there is a group of extraterrestrials that are hoping that we're going to destroy ourselves. Because they want the mineral resources. So it goes on. But that's how the universe works. The group of extraterrestrials that I'm involved in right now, thank heavens, are benevolently involved in it. We're at the focusing energy. Who really wrote these books is at the creational level, not only of this universe, but other ones. Because we are so negative on this planet right now. It's so out of balance. It's affecting their backyard. It's like when we put off a nuclear bomb. That's affecting the whole universe. So this, it's serious time. Are we going to have any Social Security? It's already gone. So what do you do? We have to think positive. What are we going to have to create? Commodities. I would suggest getting seeds, something that you can trade, other things that you can sustain. Remember the old days they told you to stock up for food for 5 years and all that? Well, we're right there again at the potential of that happening. And it's not going to hurt you to do that. If you've got friends and family away from the big cities, I think that's what you ought to do. Consider getting away, at least have the ability to get away. We're not going to be flying too much longer. You can see that happening all the way around. China just got you buying almost all of the oil production out of Iran. As you know, Iraq is a little, if you probably know, when we started bombing over in Iraq, the Soviets were running the Ramallah oil field. That's 14% of their production. And then Putin also told Bush, who said, we will not take the dollar anymore. You got to come down with gold. Aren't you reading the newspaper? Okay, well, wait 1 second. I got to change in the scenery. Barbara Marciniak wrote a book called Bringers of the Dawn, and in that, her energies were telling her that all we have to do is change our DNA pattern. Now, DNA is on a very physical level, isn't it? So when we're talking about the physical, now we got talking about the non-physical. Because physical can be changed, the DNA. When I was in Central America in the Russian embassy, and I was with the mafia and the CIA all together. They're all the same. The CIA is crooks in action. They're born liars. I mean, that professional liars is what they do. Anyway, I'm sitting there watching movies of the execution of Kennedy, so I wanted to see who really killed him and all that. I found that out. But I was there. One of the people in the audience or in the room was a doctor for Castro. And they were working on the DNA. You're talking about DNA stuff. And they have got to the point now, since the DNA is a product of your mother and your father, or what you are. In other words, that tells you how long you're going to live, approximately. What color your eyes are and all that, they're able to, if you have kids, they're able to take the DNA out of the children now, spin off the male or the female component and re-inject it back to you so you get their life, their longevity. Interesting? Castro's working on this. I got a whole bunch of details. I also, when I was in Washington, D.C., I have a friend of mine who is a medical doctor, who always walks around with two people in black suits around them, who treats the clones. I want you to think about cloning. If they've cloned a sheep, what do you think they've done? Been cloning people since 1939. These are soulless beings. Interesting? It's real simple. Y'all, let me tell you, there's three methods. I'll give you a simple method so you can see how to do it. Well, let's talk about it. If I took two cells off, the Americans' method is called duplicates, the Russians call theirs robotoids, and there's a new method. There's 8 countries making people. Anyway, if I take two cells off of your body, all we do is give them, this is a rough deal, give them an electrical charge, they'll act like a fertilized egg. Well, if you got a fertilized egg, what do we need? In vitro, we can use cows, sheep, or people. So that's what they do. And after about 14 weeks, the fetus starts developing its own blood supply, and at that point, they can transfer that into by itself and use a pituitary hormone extract to accelerate the growth of this being. Now, the being was used, the original engineering was done for spare parts, so you could have a heart or liver without any rejection. Makes a lot of sense. I even talked to the doctor about that. The problem is, this thing, you're a product of what? Of all the five feelings or the five senses that you have up to this point, am I right? So this being doesn't have any of that. But they found out if you went to the hospital and got an encephalogram, that's your memory, your brain memory. They can download it on this being, and now what do we have? A walking, talking duplicate. Now, they put them in front of a television set to program and make sure that it's working, and I'm just telling you, that's how the game works. And they do it at Bethesda Hospital. I actually talked to a nurse over there. There's one wing. They call the people the others. I mean, it's real live X-Files. The clones? Isn't it prophesied that we're going to have soulless beings in charge of the planet? I know many of our world leaders that are clones. He's a synthetic. I want you to watch George Bush on TV every other week and tell me if it's the same one. Jimmy Carter, just so you know. I know a lot, even some of the world leaders, yes. Synthetic is, remember what we just talked about when I took this gentleman up and I showed you that he was nothing more than a hologram? You ever been to Disney World? Go into the Haunted Mansion and you see this being in glass that is totally perfect? That's a hologram, right? Well, they've learned how to make a hologram that walks and talks. It only stays together 7 to 10 days. Stress breaks it down. So if there's a lot of stress, that being that they've created will start to fall apart and they have to go replace it. And then this is all sci-fi, but this is all, you start researching it. Dr. Beter contacted me. He's in Washington. He's dead now. Yeah, probably. I don't know, but his wife gave me all the data on the different clones. I got papers and papers of them. Another doctor that was in charge, the extraterrestrials shared the information with a doctor down in Albuquerque, and they contacted me because I was publishing all the books exposing the bad guys and all the things that are going on. He contacted me. He says, I got it all. We talked on the phone. I said, I'll fly down on Thursday. I talked to him on Tuesday. On Thursday, they picked him up and put him in a mental institution and gave him and basically electroshock, and he's a vegetable today. Now, well, I told you about 4.5 years ago when I lived here in Vegas, I was contacted by the ETs. I said, look, I've been, like for the last 10 years, I've been publishing books exposing the bad guys, right? You know what the ETs said? What good has that done? It's okay to know all this stuff, but what's the solution? The solution is written in those little books. That's the reason why they're more important. And I give them away. The reason why I give away the handbook, and you probably heard me on Coast to Coast, I gave 35,000 of them away one night. And we're not going to have a planet left unless we do this. That's how serious it is. I know what's good. I sat in on the meetings on planning on annihilating all you people. I mean, I sat with the governor of Colorado, and he says, I got my ticket. I said, what ticket? Yeah. He said, I'm sitting in the office with one of the Skull and Bones members. And I'm sitting with the governor, and I said, what ticket? And he said, well. And then we went into the underground facility in Australia. You've heard of that in Pine Gap that the Rockefellers built for 35,000 people? I don't have my ticket. They, when they're getting ready to go, they got a facility because they know the northern hemisphere is going to have it in spades. So does that mean for you to run to the southern hemisphere? Well, 4 weeks ago, a good friend of mine, Brian O'Leary, the Apollo astronaut, has moved to Ecuador. He's in the Valley of Longevity. He says, I know what's coming down. He also knew we never made it to the moon. Another lie. Yes.
I've been going through this for a few years, and some of my questions are, first of all, I don't know how my name ever came up on your database. It's a very curious spot for me. I've read the book that you sent me. I appreciate that. I was a part of some of the groups here quite a few years ago that taught things like spike training and started the community up at Kuski and Kamiai. Most of the instructors...
Bo Greitz.
Yeah.
Bo and I ran around together. I actually helped finance part of his thing.
Yeah, I was an instructor for phase 2 and 3.
Yeah.
What I'm curious about is most of the instructors and the people that have been in that realm have had pretty much of a hardship since all those came around. And you're able to go around, give away books, and do a lot of the same work that we had been doing. And I don't understand how... What kind of immunity did you get that the rest of us that did some of the same work?
I have to go back a long time ago when I remember when I was running around with the guys when I was younger with my dad and stuff. I asked a lot of questions that went out. And the same question is, why am I out here? Why am I alive? Because my CIA buddies, they do two things. They want to know how far along the other side's on. And they also figure that most people aren't going to do anything. They think they've won already.
Well, I understand that, and I'm listening to you saying this, and you're sharing it with all these people, and I don't think some of them might realize how real this is and how much
that's the problem.
Of people have gone through and done this.
It's the biggest challenge in the world, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's even Bo. Where is Bo grow? You all know Bo Greitz, the most highly decorated Marine, right? He and I, we ran around lecturing. You know where Bo drew the line with me? Extraterrestrials. Because he walks around with his little Bible. Sure, Bo ran for president. He moved, him and his wife, they moved to Idaho, but Bo lives right down here right now, Boulder City. He ran for president of the United States. We ran all over the country. I thought, man, we have a chance to change the bad guys up here. But it isn't. They have so much control, they control the voting system. The whole thing is a lie. I don't care if you vote, they rig the votes. We go down here to the casino, what does it say, 97% they pay? They don't, like my brother used to run the Golden Nugget downtown. He said, look, we don't build tall buildings selling hot dogs. That's the way this whole system is run. Since you're dealing in a game of monopoly, using their money, which is nothing but a promise to pay more money, and it's going apart, our monopoly game is falling apart big time. And yes, how serious are we? We're almost at the end where this thing's, you know, people are going to wake up in total shock, and out of the chaos, because that's the only way it's going to work, we'll be able to create something new. You got the book, I don't know how we got your name, but thousands of people are shunning these books all over the place. I don't know.
You know, a lot of the people, team members that taught the spike training were spooks, and their life got changed.
Again, they don't. Look, I was the head of the CIA. Well, Barry, tell you, I was one of my friends was the head of the CIA for Latin America. He's the biggest crook there is. Seriously. These guys, that's all they do. They learn to see how far along what they do and how they can infiltrate, and that's part of their job. I'm not out there. I made my money. I'm not doing anything. I'm trying to do a share with you because all the money's going to go away. And I'm smarter than the next guy in one way because I got an advance notice. So I'm moving my assets into gold and silver, and it's not paper. It's pure gold and silver. Yes, ma'am.
I've got two questions. Do you know, like, how soon that this will all really be?
It's 9:15. It started at 6. No, the game's already on right now. They're behind schedule. The Plan 2000 that Jimmy Carter and I said in on the meetings was to get the war started in the Middle East in the year 2000. So we're behind schedule. But remember, they have to have this culminated and finished, the fait accompli, by the year 2012. And why? The end of the Mayan calendar. We got to follow the prophecies. We got to do all of the things that's necessary. We wrote the books. When the book of Revelation said we're going to be doing all these things, they got to have everybody lined up in their different camps, not any of them knowing the real story. If you read all of these books, you'll understand the whole story, and it is a huge game of the creation as we're looking at this. Next question.
The second question was, out of the terrestrials, you said there was a group that wanted to destroy us, and then there's the group that you communicated
yes.
with that wanted to enlighten us.
Yes.
What, do you know the ratio of good compared to the evil as far as terrestrials as their whole population? Like, and how much of the group is like evil, and how much of their group?
Well, let's come back and let's think about things from a very. The universe is logical, mysterious. Don't make it mystical. If you take as a product of thought, and let's begin what I was talking about, if we put out from a logical basis a plus one, we have to have an equal and opposite amount, right? Minus one. If I double the power, I got a plus two, and then we got a minus two, and so on. And that's basically the periodic table of elements. Rather than what I used at in chemistry and mines and all that, we used the light deal, what was done by Walter Russell at the University of Science on there, as they started getting information from Germain, another extraterrestrial that is communicating through people. And all of you can communicate. It's just when we get giving them permission to do that and then coming into balance of what's going on. Again, that's the next question. I was just with Mark Kimmel, and he and I lectured down in Fort Lauderdale the week ago Sunday. And Mark has written a book called Trillion. His sources and his extraterrestrials say there's at least 50,000 planets in this galaxy inhabited by humanoids. If you can imagine, if you're talking about the 12 strand and all the other ones, can you imagine a planet where people live to be 1,000 years old with no disease, no sickness, and no wars? There was one. No, Era. No, never were. This planet has always been, let me explain to you where we all come from. Because I went running around again, I'll tell you some more of the story. Well, on this planet, everything was going along great. The people were the artists, they were developing, they were creating things. They were creating things that were in balance, like we didn't make a car that fell apart. It was meant for everybody to use, and it didn't affect the environment. Think about that. Anyway, they were being attacked by bad guys in the universe. Remember the law? Thou shalt not murder thy fellow man in thought or deed. So their solution to this, yeah, they could protect themselves, they looked around for less developed humanoids on the evolutionary scale, and that's where they played with the DNA. They gave them limited life. Instead of 1,000 years, how much do we have? They gave them the intelligence to act as their warriors. And so they did the fighting, hoping that in the long run, everything would balance out. The trouble is what they created turned on them. So their solution then was to erase their memories and send them down to a place that has been used as a prison planet. Remember what we did in England and France? Where did we send the prisoners? We're kind of the outback of the universe. And the history of the planet is really showing that. How many of you read all of Zechariah Sitchin's books, where he translated the Sumerian tablets, saying basically the same thing? When I went to Japan, and I spent some time at Sotsubashi University in Tokyo, their most ancient documents said they came from a boat from the sky.
First they learned to walk.
Go to Xi'an, if you've been over there in China. Xi'an's where all the terracotta figures are in the ground. They also have pyramids over there. They came from the star. The word Dogon, what does that mean? Star people. So what you're looking at is we're all an amalgamation. There's about seven main races on the planet. When I was in Australia, I went to the outback, and on the outback's absolutely worse than the desert out here. And there was like five of us. We flew in on a small plane. I just wanted to know what the outback was all about. Well, it was nothing. There was nothing as far as I could see. And I turned around, and all of a sudden a guy started talking to me, and there's a little Aborigine about this tall. I don't know where he came from. Yeah, and he says, what are you doing here? And I said, I'm seeing what the planet's all about. And he says, are you sure? And I said, yeah. And he says, you're not a missionary, are you? And I said, no, I'm not. And he says, well, good. He said, turn around. And I turn around. He says, see that up there? And then he pointed at the sun. He says, see that? That's my God. He says, I can live without your God. You can't live without mine. I turn around and talk to my friends, and I turn around and he disappeared. I don't know where he went. But that really affected me that day. I got to thinking about that. Because that's right. They've been talking to the hierarchy, and they've been given, since they're not part of this sequence, they have been given permission not to reincarnate, so they're not having children. Now, the mixed ones that are mixed, they still have some, but not the, the pure blood Aborigines. Interesting. They know what's coming down. So we're getting clues. You know, there's people with blue skin in India. You familiar with that? Sure. We have all kinds of things. The between Spain and France is what? The Basque people. Basque people originally of Atlantis. They have their own language. Yes, ma'am. Well, when I running around, I published books on about 8 of them. So that's there's a lot more than it's out there. The ones I'm involved in right now, I mean, they're continually, they're here now. They're observing what we're doing, and they're observing you. Like I say, we'll get it. But there's physical ones. I told you when we saw that attorney, and I told him that I couldn't do anything. I got at that time I had a little car, a little 450 SL convertible out in California, and I was living in North County, San Diego, in La Costa. I had my top down and everything. We had one of those beam ships that I showed you pictures of, followed us for about a half an hour in broad daylight. Just to remind me, what was happening to me was it was a real life X-Files, frankly. I just, duh. Yes, ma'am. There's a little prayer in that little book when you get to reading it a couple of times, and just in there, ask them, say, I'm a human becoming, and show me whatever you need to be, you know, whatever you need to do to activate whatever your job's going to be in the future. And how quick is this happening? I can say it has begun. Just like you and I. I was just give you an idea how it works. When I have telepathic messages, I was on KCMO radio in Kansas City, and the host in there was asking me how I communicate. And I said, well, sometimes I communicate just like you and I. We're like in a meeting. We're very physical. I said, most of the stuff is telepathically, and it's basically a dimensional shift. It's kind of like having a cell phone without the cell phone. Anyway, I'm sitting here with the host on KCMO, and he said, yeah, how does this really work, you know, this telepathic thing? And I said, well, I was trying to explain to him, and then he asked me a question, and I paused. He threw off his headsets, threw them down on everything, because they answered him. He went out of the room, and just totally bananas, and I'm sitting in there in the studio now, and there's no host, right? He come running back in, and now this is the second biggest radio station in Kansas City. He come back in and he explained to the people. Of course, I had like 500 people the next day at my lecture. You know, because I can't tell you how, because I don't know what your mission is. Each one of us have a different mission in the days ahead. And since there is no age, age is just attitude, we're all important at this minute. All of us. Unfortunately, the kids have been so programmed right now, it's hard to get them to look beyond the Super Bowl and the other stuff that's happening, because they've been programmed right now to act as warriors. Did you notice that? As soon as we give the kids, as soon as they get out, they get a little war game. They start watching these computer games. Even when you join the Army right now, you stand in front of a computer, don't you? And they're sitting there telling you how to kill people. During World War I and World War II, fewer than 17% of our soldiers would actually take a gun and shoot somebody. Did you know that? So what did they do? They'd make it so everything is a virtual reality game today. What did they do in Littleton High School? The kids just think it's an extension of the game. When you go down and buy a Pokemon game, do you know what that means? It's a Japanese game, means pocket monster. It's programming the way you think. You're being programmed on everything you do. The best thing you can do, pull the plug out of the wall. Because there's subliminal information coming on the TVs right now. Who writes the laws? The question was, I heard that was against the law. Who writes the laws? Who controls everything? It's whatever they want. The interpretation is, what is the definition of the? You understand? You get it. I've been in court in Nevada for probably 10 years, and I found so much. The judge would be thrown out. I even appealed the judge's decision to the United States Supreme Court. Because I put some assets on them with the court. Between, there was two parties. I was named one and they were. And I said, if that's a big deal, I'll put it on The judge took my assets. He dismissed everything against me. She would give me my money back, right? He gave it away to somebody else that wasn't even a party to the lawsuit. Seriously.
Because he can.
Pardon?
Because he can.
Yeah. So I appealed him to the, you know, to the, in fact, I went against the board, you know, and I went to the Supreme Court of Nevada. And, you know, they only hear a few of the cases, but I just said, well, this cannot be, but they did it. So I found out, again, the rule of law, or this game of law right now, is it's just a game again. And I studied law. Mine was business law. I wanted all the contracts, and I did everything, and I did go to college on that, too. But it's just a Mickey Mouse game, because that's all they do. The whole thing is corrupted at this point. We don't have any laws that are... Whoever has the most money wins. Insurance companies will never pay anything, because they can delay paying you forever. That's part of their game. Yes, sir.
Are you familiar with a website called the Dove of something or other, and they're talking about this Sarah, N-E-S-A-R-A?
Okay, the question was, there's a website called the Dove, and am I familiar with the Nasara program? The Nasara program is a bunch of idiots that have given some money to this guy down there, and says that we're going to bring back the United States under the Constitution that we have, and all of your debts are going to be forgiven. And boy, are you smoking wacky tobacco. Contact Ron Paul, because that's the one that brought in this stuff, and then the Nasara program has no bearing on that. Do you think we have Congress that's going to give back, get rid of all your debts? You got to be logical about it. This is a monopoly game. They own the game. You're not going to use any of their players. The new card, the World Cash card that you're going to get when you sign up for it, if you're one of them they want to keep alive, I will tell you this. I looked at the paperwork, and if you're over age 44, you're an expendable container. Unless you have a talent that they... Like my son's a nuclear physicist, right? He's in the top 100 scientists in the world. They want him. It depends on what your need's going to be, or if you're in one of the inner group at the very top. I mean, look at Donald Rumsfeld. He's not even in the government, right? Sits down, he's got a little house in Taos, New Mexico, and he's sitting over there, right? The people had a march on him about a year ago. You maybe heard about this little girl down there. There was a guy in Florida that wrote a book called Vote Scam, remember that? The Collier? Vicky Collier lives in Taos. She decided to get all the 300 people to march on Rumsfeld House. Had 2,000. So they shut it all down. He was just there over Christmas. He happens to live next door to one of my good friends. he was part of there too. But it's all, they're going to protect the inner group no matter what. Remember, nepotism's going to do that. They're going to make sure whatever happens, you're going to be protected. If you do what they tell you. Now, if they decide, and now here's the other bad thing. When I'm sitting here talking to the population, we're sitting here about population reduction. And again, I'm sitting on the meetings, when, like, let's say there was 12 people in the room. Half of us adjourned to another room, and we talked about getting rid of some of the people we were just with. So what I'm going to tell you is, it's like being in on a den of rattlesnakes, scorpions, and black widows. Each one of them capable of killing each other in the right condition. I don't know who's going to end up on top or whether we're going to have a planet left. I do know the goal is to have this completed in the next 8 years. Year 2012.
Why are they seeing the clouds of the government causing all this?
Well, the question is, what are they seeding the clouds, and why did we have chemtrails? I just published the book on chemtrails, and the information has come forth. Remember I told you that we have a band of energy around the planet, or radiation that's 4 miles thick. We're allowing the gamma and everything. How can we, you as a scientist now, what would you do to try to keep the gamma and ultraviolet coming down here and killing more life forms off? These scientists put together, and they decided we'll put together a web of chemicals that are going to sit up here to help to keep the radiation down from the planet, not figuring in the power of the jet stream. So if we had a web of, for instance, gold. Gold is an element that is used in all the planets because it doesn't dissolve. You can spin it as fine as thread, And if you can use it, it's used to purify the air. And they do that on other planets. So what we're trying to do, these guys are trying to create this thing. As you know, they changed the JP-4, the jet fuel, and changed the new conditioner on it. So all the planes were going up there putting this fuel up here to create this web. And because of the winds, we disperse and it's coming down. And what's it doing to you now? It's causing a lot of environmental. But remember, you're an expendable container anyway. They don't care because the plan is, again, to reduce the population down to 20 million Americans. That's the goal. Remember, they wouldn't put things out there unless they have protection for themselves. So you have to look at it. You always have. They always have the other side of the coin.
Have you been in planted like Van Passel down in the
Yucca Valley? No. Look, I knew Van Tassel a long time ago, and they were talking about the implants and everything. Those people who agree to be in, let's say, an extension of them, so they can monitor you. Remember when we sent down monitors on the planet? They're sending down drones. Some people volunteered, maybe in another life form, actually, or in another life. They come in at this time to act so they could monitor it, since time doesn't exist. As the ETs tell me, only clarity of experience. So all of these things are part of the puzzle. I don't have all the answers to yet. I'm asking, but nor does it make any difference at this point. I do know that there's these little groups forming all around the planet with this little blue book everywhere. And I'm flying all over. I'm having a good time. And a lot of people are waking up, and amazing things are happening. Yes, ma'am. My website is nohoax.com, and if you go to that website now, we just changed it 2 weeks ago, and there is an internet group that's setting up little functions all over the place, and they're joining, you know, it's got some things on it, but there's groups following all over the place. How many of you have seen the video 9/11, the Great Illusion, by the one that's done out of Texas by George Humphrey? George Humphrey's got probably, I have it, it's $11 on my catalog. It's a 2.5 hour video. It's really a good one. It tells you what happened on 9/11. Anyway, I went down to his group. He has 100 people a week that meet on these books. George Humphrey. Take my catalog, it's on the back page.
Okay.
They're having meetings on this material in these books so they can rethink the ending of the story. Since everything is a product of the thought, let's rethink the ending of the story. But I don't know what the ending's going to be yet, so we have to call on however you view God. And I just told you my definition, and God is the creation's thinking. If the creation has put together all this to contemplate itself, it must have a solution to all of this. Yes, ma'am.
I was at a convention when David Moorhead was about visualization.
Yes. You were at a convention where David Moorhead said visualization? That's what we're talking about. But the problem is with our visualization is based on the five senses. Let me tell you how you think. You guys don't know how you think? Remember we talked about the five senses? Smelling, touching, tasting, and all of that. The truth is, when the sun comes up in the morning, there's a hormone that goes in your body. You all familiar with that hormone? Serotonin? That activates you to be in what we call the 3D world. When the sun goes down, there's another hormone that grows, and what do they call that? Yeah, serotonin during the day and melatonin at night, right? Between the hours of midnight and 4, if you give them permission, that's where the downloading and uploading happens. Where you ask, you'll get the best dreams and the best visualization between those hours, because theoretically your body's asleep, and now we're talking about pure spirit uploading and downloading, because you're basically a computer. And let's go back to the next thing. All thought from outside of you comes through your ductless glands in your brain. Study it and check it out. And then you find out if thought is out there, and if I can pull you up on top of this stage and have everybody think that you're weak, what did I do? I mean, you just demonstrated just what we're talking about. Okay, now we have to start going. There's another one. The thought above all of us, which is the thought of the creation, and we need all the help we can get, don't you think? And I want to thank you. I love you guys for coming down here and listening to me tonight. You got any more questions? Yes.
John Lear, many years ago, claims that there's
John's a friend of mine. John, actually, I was on the Art Bell show, and John wrote me a letter and said I was being set up. Just to give you, you know, no, it was a long time ago. I got set up recently with him again, too, but that's making a difference. I don't care. It doesn't, you know, it's whatever it is to get people awakened. No, neither one of the groups, they all understand the laws that you have right there, and they all of them have the same effect, and it's explained in the second book, I think, Embracing the Rainbow, about the extraterrestrials. The first one doesn't, but the second one goes into the extraterrestrials, because it's not really a focus for all of us right now. Extraterrestrials have their own agenda, and if you read page 80, 78 through 80 of the handbook, just read the material. It'll tell you a little bit about dimensions and thought and how it works. And John and others, you know, bless them for out awakening you at the level that you're at.
Why do the Palladians call God all there is?
Above all things is a creation. That's what the Palladians said. I remember, I became in contact with the Palladians, but that since went away. I became in contact with the Umos, and I became the people from Mirasol. But then when I became in contact with, you call it at the spirit level, that's another one. And there's many levels of that. The focusing energy at the creation of thought is the one that said actually you're writing these books that you're reading.
Are you psychic, like
fantastic? No, I'm not. What does psychic mean? Here's a problem that I have with remote viewing and psychic technology. You have to give permission. And if people come out and they say, I'm remote viewing, because there's a lot of them talking about going outside of your body, you can learn soul travel, and you're going somewhere else, you have violated one of the games or the premises, and that's basically the free will thing. You're going over to try to take control. I mean, I sat with Bob Beck, and he was telling me about all the government experiments of doing soul travel and checking out what other people are thinking. There has to be a repercussion to all of that. You just can't go do that. Even the ETs that are coming down here and picking people up. We don't know what their story is, but remember, in the long run, it all has to come back in balance. The four laws is the law of attraction, what you put out, you're going to get back. The second one is the law of intent. What did you intend for the action of your thought? The third one you have is the law of allowance. You have to allow that thought to be made manifest. And what's the fourth law? Balance. If it's not in balance, it's got to come undone, and we're out of balance. The question is Saddam Hussein the real one? I have no idea, but he was CIA. Does Castro was CIA? I'm telling you, if CIA, these crooks in action are all part. Remember, Castro was being supplied by everything for us to go after Iran, if you remember. Obviously, he did something wrong, so what did they do? They just turned him into, you got a conflict resolution, you create the enemy. Eventually, when they reduce the world's population down to 500 million or less, we're going to have to create some enemy. Guess who that's going to be? The extraterrestrials from space. And it's all going to culminate about the year. Right now, you're seeing spacecraft all around the planet. That's to awaken you that there's something else going on. And why don't they come down here and save us? Again, it's a prime directive, non-interference. We can't interfere. We can give you information. You got to do it. Guys, I'm giving you the instruction book to get out of this mess. Yes. Yeah, Durango, Pagosa. That's correct. The question was the Four Corners area. It's publicized that the Indians are doing underground stuff. They're getting ready. They will. The Indian territory will be probably fairly safe if you're allowed to be over there. And that's so that you can look down, there are small communities. Again, you have to be in balance. You have to figure a way to stay alive when there's no Social Security, and you're going to have to provide all these things. Yes, ma'am. Yeah, Pagosa Springs, a little town about 20 miles exactly east of Durango. Durango has, it's a nice little town, but it has a tremendous water problem. It's also at 8,000 feet. It's going to be relatively safe because there's not a lot of people. It's a college town. Pagosa Springs has a lot of retirees, better water. It's a climate. Again, I'm just, these are things that you're looking at. I travel all over. I've looked up, at, you know, I went to the East Coast. I liked Asheville, but I hate humidity. In the Western United States, it's got a better deal without that. So, any other questions? Hey. No, he doesn't.
Well, he goes into areas such as reptiles and going.
David got his research from Arizona Wilder, who I lectured with out in California. And I checked with, you know, I said with Arizona, because, you know, she's a normal secretary per se. That isn't her real name. And then I checked with my CIA buddies, and it's kind of like a few other ones out here. Just be careful of all that information. Regardless of the bloodlines, whether they're reptilian or not, I don't really care. I'm not focusing on. Now, Dave and I talked about that. Yeah, if you got nepotism within the ruling classes, they're going to make sure that they keep going on that. What difference does that make right now? I mean, if you go to China, do you think they're worried about them? China's got a billion, they admitted this last week. You hear that? 1,300,000,000 people. Guys, if you have a chance to go to China, you have no idea what that is. That's five times our population. All along the Yangtze River, which is not even going to the ocean right now. They're using all the water supply. They have all the money. They're the largest, basically we're the largest debtor nation in the world, and they're the largest creditor nation, and they've got 100,000,000 men ready for military. Remember what George Washington's dream was? 100,000,000 Chinese are gonna walk across the Bering Strait and come down through the Northwest. I happen to know that what's scheduled right now, the Chinese, and I sat in China. I used to have friends in the government over. I sat with them when I showed them all the pretty pictures of Billy Meyer and all that. They have a government publication that comes out monthly on the ongoing direct contacts in China. They already know about it. They're also going to sit back, and they're in the massive observer mode as they control the thing, because they're going to sit back and watch us totally destroy. They got extraterrestrial craft that have fallen. And they figure they're going to use that technology they've got off the extraterrestrial craft to provide the free energy to run everything as we're destroyed ourselves.
Is Billy Meyer spreading the word?
Billy Meyer has got, yeah, he is. But nobody, you know, he's been doing it for so long, and he has so much control on it, very few people, you know, it's like I have his book in my Cadillac, nobody buys it. It's past that point. Everybody wants to know what's happening today. You know, it's the old thing. It's like I tell people, it's okay to look back. Don't stare. Only thing that exists is right now. That's all that exists and what we create in the future. No, I'm not. I haven't read that book. The question was, yeah, Bob Lazar and the crew was working with the extraterrestrials at Area 51. Our government has been doing that. I actually published a book called UFO Crash at Aztec. Went into the 18 crashes in New Mexico. Did you know? 18 of them. Yeah, I lectured a few months ago in Aztec, New Mexico, and they have a museum down there about the crash. So 18 different ones on these craft material. Like Colonel Corso wrote a book the day after. You can get it at the bookstore right now. That's where they retrofitted all the engineering so we have, quote, computers, fiber optics, and everything right off alien spacecraft. That's how our technology jumped. I don't have a number. What John says he's 36, that's maybe from his connections on it. There may be a heck of a lot more. Yeah, I would. According to Kimmel, and he was taken aboard the craft. And I mean, if you read his book, I wouldn't limit anything to numbers. I wouldn't put any kind of numbers. Just say that, hey, we're the center point in the universe right now. We want to thank these people. I'm sorry, you guys are going to Santo Domingo, the Dominican Republic. They have to catch a plane. The question was, have I ever spoken at the Palms Hotel at the UFO convention? I've been there at the convention. I've talked to the people down there. Wendell Stevens, who's is a close friend of mine, ended up running around the world for him on a couple of things. The problem is that you're speaking to the choir. And I don't want to speak to the choir. We want to speak to people that are aware of some of this. We want people to get, rather than focusing on the ETs, on what they're doing and what's happening out here, I want to focus on solutions right now and having it so you guys can survive in the days ahead. That's all I'm interested in. Yes, ma'am. The question is, what can you do politically? Get in the observer mode, because all everything is elected is being manipulated into position. Yeah, the voting system, the vote scam tells it, it's all done by the Electoral College, which is already bought and paid for. I mean, you don't know the behind it. Why did Kerry resign all of a sudden? Even though he won New Mexico, he won Ohio. They don't want any of you to know what really has occurred, because it's a manipulative game. So the question is, I don't vote. When I found, I thought I was doing a good thing voting too, but I'm sitting here talking to the guy that is the front man for the guys that are controlling the game, said he didn't care, they control them both. What did that tell you? It doesn't make any difference, because it's going to end up, let's have our two parties, but the same game is going to happen, just moving the players in different directions. I didn't waste your time. No. Of course. Carrie's a member of the Skull and Bones Society. Skull and Bones. Well, I'd rather have you just read that in the books. There's plenty of people that have written about it. The Skull and Bones is a secret society, very satanic. The interesting thing in is young George, that's the only society that he's in, and his name is temporary in the skull. Yes, the skull. Yeah, now Prescott Bush put that in there. And that's, see, that you get the inner circle going. It's like right now they're talking about Jeb being there. Isn't that, talking about the next president? I want you to look at the players. Since we've got a huge game, it's being manipulated right now. Which two people were behind George Bush right now talking about the UN problem in the Far East to help? No. Bill Clinton and George Sr. Wouldn't it be a good position to put Bill Clinton in, the head of the UN? Well, I want you to think about first of all, you probably don't know how the UN structured is. The UN structured right now, you got Kofi Annan. In case of a national emergency, it says 30 days, Bush becomes king for the day. At the end of 30 days, the head of the UN takes over. I expect within a short period of time, he will be gone. Because the second in command at the United Nations is and always has been a Russian. The New World Order is a socialist dictatorship. So what you're seeing at the game, I'm just trying to put pieces together for you.
Do the Pleiadians care about this, or do they want chaos?
No, the Pleiadians don't want anything. They want us. We got the chaos right here. Don't you feel chaotic? Hey, out of the chaos, we're going to create something new. That's what the universe works on, the chaos theory. I don't know what we're going to create. I really don't. Everything that we've done hasn't worked. No. Mm-mm. Well, the only one that makes sense is these books, because I'm calling on higher energy, if you want to look at it, at thought itself, to assist us in creating something new.
Who actually
Yeah.
You channel that?
Pardon?
You channel it?
I have agreed to be the publisher for the ETs. The history of the planet is we deify or crucify the messenger. Isn't that right? Okay, so when you go into it, there is no author. That's them. I am the publisher. Just leave it at that. And then you can be, because I don't really care. You guys are, you know, you guys should all be in contact.
I got to ask, you slid over it so fast. I want to go back. You said, you either said or implied, that you know who killed Jeff Nick. Who did that?
There was a guy by the name of Fidel Castro that Kennedy was all messed up with because he brought in the Russians down there with the missiles and all that. And Kennedy was mafia. He sent down two mafia teams to take out Castro. Castro was CIA. Castro says, I'll play your silly game. So he brought down Ferry and Oswald down to Cuba, remember? He also, there was nine shooters. I was in Albuquerque, New Mexico. There's a federal court case where three of the killers were taken out by one of our CIA people who lives in Albuquerque, and I have all of his documents. Castro orchestrated all this thing because of exactly, he said, you got your teams, I'll take it out. But we couldn't go after Castro because that's premature. We would have started World War III prematurely. So the only thing we could do is what? Embargo Cuba. Isn't that the only communist country in the entire world that's still embargoed? It's an old mafia deal. Pardon? That's right, but he's still the only one. It doesn't work, but what'd they do? Build a brand new airport down in Havana just now? All the Europeans come to Havana and go to Latin America? Yeah, but that was their tit for tat. That was going to go on. That's who actually orchestrated it.
There's a time element involved in Cuba when you start Americans
coming first. Don't worry about what's going on over there because that's all planned yet. Everything's being planned and you don't have to worry about it coming apart. There's a lot of Americans that are moving into position right now to open up Cuba as we talk. You can go down there in a minute. No, he's not. No. We are already involved with Russia. Putin, and this is in the paper, if you read it, Putin just talked, this was only a month ago. Putin just said, I've got nuclear missiles. He's got 22,000 nuclear missiles. We only got 10,000. Before the Iraqi thing, they had signed an agreement to cut down their nuclear arsenal over the next 10 years to half. That means they'd have 10,000, we'd have 5,000. We do not have the technical ability to stop any of the nuclear stuff. None of our armament is there. The Russians have it all. I don't know the answer to that. All I know is that Vegas is going to go away. It'll be vaporized in a minute. the SDI stuff and all that. You know, I haven't been keeping track of all, our defense system does not work. We don't have the ability to do that. We can't take out any of their cosmospheres that are floating over the United States because if we do, we might possibly start the nuclear explosion beforehand because they're above, right? So we're not going to do that. I mean, it's a real, there's a game playing for world right now and the game is happening, like I say, the old communist thing is feign weakness while we grow strong. And not only that, we loaned them the money to do it in the first place. Hey, with all that, I'm going to cut. Yeah. End of it. I want to thank you all for showing up. And I hope I shared some information with you. They're going to throw me out of this place. Did you learn anything? And I love you all. Oh.
I didn't say at first that I was going to, you know, make your mind think a little bit tonight. I showed you some pictures, basically, of spacecraft, and as you can see, they do become physical. And what I was trying to also tell you that you're nothing more than a hologram, if I remember right. Who wants to volunteer to come up here so I can prove to everybody that you're a hologram? Anybody? You'll do that? Sure, come on. We'll have two of you up here.
No? Okay. Well, anybody. I don't care. Just yourself.
Okay. What do you want me to do?
Well, you can stand right here. That's fine. I think he can catch it. What is happening is all we are is a hologram of light that's condensed, and we're held together by the thought that's within ourselves and our soul that's within. Now, there's several layers of it. The first layer that's outside of it is our etheric field or our thought field, where all thought is. It's outside of your body. Thought comes into your ductless glands and through your senses. It's then retained into your brain, which is mostly water, of the information that you get on a daily basis. Meanwhile, we have a gentleman here. Put your arm out, anyone you want to. Now, everybody knows kinesiology. I'm going to push down on the arm. Is that okay?
Yeah.
You hold it up?
Yeah.
Okay, now, it's fairly strong. Now, I want you to, we're going to use some subtle energy. You keep, I know, these might work. Okay, now, hold it up. I want you to look at one of those lights up there. Okay. You see what it did? That light up there is affecting the subtle energy that we had around him, and that's affecting our kids in school big time. Now, hold your arm up. You got your energy back. You do now because yeah. You're not looking at it. You're holding it. Okay, now watch this. Ready?
Yeah.
Oh, that's...
Now, did I do anything? I cut his... See? Now, do you understand? Are you nothing? Yeah. Now, you understand a little bit more about energies and how subtle you are and how we can manipulate you by satellite? Mm-hmm. Now, I have some things they call blues busters. These are full spectrum bulbs. Kids going to school today in classes are under lights like this. And what do you think they do to your body over a long period of time? Why do you think we have our kids call them Ritalin kids? Because they're confused. We're playing with subtle energies, and subtle energies going to make you so sick, you make you so weak, and you don't know it. Now, I have some other things I could do, but I didn't bring my charts tonight, because sometimes I bring charts and I hold them up and let you mentally put your thoughts out to him to make him weak, and the same thing will happen. We could try it. No, but that's all right. You can sit down. Anyway, you got to experience it. Isn't that a strange feeling?
You got to zip me up.
No, you're zipped up. No, you come back. You're okay. What it's saying is, I put back, what you're doing is like cutting a wave. All of you have gone into a room and you felt somebody behind you. That's because their energy is putting out. Now wait. Let's make it more fun. Because we're all interacting with each other all the time on a whole planetary basis, whether you know it or not. If I'm putting out my energy right now, I'm going to lay it on you. When they tell you putting energy out, put your hands up. At the end of your hands, you can feel my energy. I just want you to do it. I'm going to send some pulses. That means I'm interacting. Feel real light at the end of your tips. Do you feel it? All of you should start feeling something. Now do something different. Pull your hands like this and just move them. Now what do you feel? Just imagine that all we are is condensed light. And another thing we are, we seem to retain we like to be a victim. And we retain from a soul level how sick we were. Or we retain, do we want to be sick? Or we start picking up diseases. And so we create things to break down this body. We have another book in the back that Dr. Holub, who's a doctor who in Los Angeles, it develops, called Psychokinesiology. What it determines is, when did you cause the illness in the first place? And you can go in and release your illnesses. Because a lot of stuff we're doing to ourselves, we're also being conditioned by lights, just like I just showed you. Can you imagine that? Just subtle, that's called subtle energies. And since thought is a subtle energy, we can do that to other people. If you think bad things, remember what I told you about one of the laws, thou shalt not murder thy fellow man in thought or deed? Can you imagine maintaining your balance every day and what the planet would be like if we had to do that? That's the rule book that we got back there, the spiritual laws, and I've broken them all. And you probably have too. And they say, we're out of balance. So what do we got to have to do? We have to figure a way. Unfortunately, the information that I have right now is not good to share with you, in that we have gone too far and we aren't going to be able to save the planet per se, but there's going to be some of you that are going to be able to go through the days ahead that are scheduled on both levels. The scheduling is the planet is going to do some cleansing on its own. We got the Earth getting ready to do some major shifting. I'm talking about earthquakes. I was sharing the one about in San Francisco. There's many psychics that have been telling you about the oceans moving and the volcanoes. Everybody knows and it feels there's something going on. I don't know the degree and where they're going to be. I have some feelings about some stuff at that point. I know it's going to be gradually increasing, so there's going to be incredible chaos on the planet. At this minute, I want to open it up to questions on anything that you may have, and I'll try to answer you what I know or I can share. Does that sound like a fair plan? Yes, ma'am. The question was, do I have any sense of the timeline? As I came over here today, I picked up USA Today magazine, and I put a copy of it, USA Today the paper, on the front page of it, and what it is to do with Russia. And right next to it, I have some newsletters I'm going to give to you about Russia. They are planning to attacking the United States. It could be any minute at this minute. When would be a good time to attack?
Wintertime.
Tomorrow.
Sunday morning.
Tomorrow night. Think about this. I'm just saying, it could happen at any time. The Soviets have nuclear submarines, this is my sources, submarines on both sides of the United States. They have satellites above the United States, they call them cosmospheres. Each one of them have 5 nuclear missiles aimed at the main cities of the United States. We couldn't take them out because our military has been charged. We have set everything into motion, so we no longer have a military. We have a police force. It's police action. It's not defense. We have taken down all of our nuclear missiles. My son is a nuclear physicist. He's on contract with, works for Bechtel. They're on contract with the Soviets. He's dismantling the 30-year-old nuclear missiles in Russia right now, but they've got the brand new ones. Last week, the Russians made a sweep. They have one that's launched in the back of a 50-foot trailer. It goes down the road at 50 miles an hour, like our highway trucks are. Stops 10 minutes later, it launched, and 6,000 miles the missile went and hit its target. We aren't even doing that. We don't have any defense. In fact, our illustrious President Clinton signed into law that we'll take 30 days before we respond to a nuclear attack. What does that mean? Kind of all over. Now, I also got to tell you a couple other things you need to research. Now, everybody hears about the United Nations and what's going on. The UN and the Secretary General is the figurehead for the UN, which is sitting on Rockefeller property. Now, David is a real interesting man. David owns 4.5% between his own personal holdings, his trust holdings, and the Chase Manhattan holdings of 90% of the world's corporations. 4.5% is voting control of 90% of what you think and do and act and buy. Voting control, one man. Now, there's a book that Dr. Coleman wrote called The Committee of 300. That's a conspirator's hierarchy because people heard about, well, there's 300 people in the world that supposedly control the world. He names them, how they got into power, and then you can understand a little bit more. The books have been out a long time. Henry Ford wrote a book. Actually, he published a lot. He has his own that he's put together, too. I have some of them in my catalog, and he'll describe who the world leaders are and what they can do. Frankly, I don't even get focused on them anymore. Some of them are still my friends, and I still talk to them. I mean, it's interesting what they are. They just figured that they won the game on the physical dimension, but we all know that's only part of it, isn't it? Since we are nothing more than a spirit having a physical experience, hey, let's do the best we can. Next question. Yes, sir.
You may not know, but Portland is consistently heavily sprayed in the air by who knows what. Do you have any information on what
For you that are interested in the contrail situation, rather than me do anything, I brought a video tonight that's 2 hours long by four doctors, eminent people, it's back at my table. We'll go into the chemtrails and what they speculate on what the situation. I've heard several stories after looking at the video. It's not that they're not doing it. My own personal belief is that they're setting up other viruses and things into our body. Some of my sources are saying, yeah, they're doing that so that we will become allergic to certain things. So when they come back and respray us again, our body, the antigens will set up and coagulate the blood. What does that do? The Soviets, by the way, well, Larry Harris, I had as a friend of mine, Larry Harris and Bill Levitt went to Las Vegas, and you all read about that in the paper a couple years ago. I'm responsible for that mess. They were arrested because they were investigating what would the Iraqi people were doing. The women were bringing over the biologicals in their vaginal cavities, bringing in anthrax and bubonic plague, and they set up cells throughout the United States to distribute it. They now have got what they call the triple cocktail that's developed with the Russians. It's anthrax, bubonic plague, and smallpox. And at that point, these things can be released in the air, and you have 3 days to live. My suggestion is, according to Larry, the only thing that'll do any good immediately is tetracycline. And you can get tetracycline by going to your veterinary store and say you got a sick dog. It's the same stuff. And you can get it. And then it's, the dosage is, I believe, 500 milligrams, 8 hours. Don't take it too long, but if you hear anything's going on, better have some tetracycline around because it's a massive, broad-spectrum antibiotic. Anyway, that goes in conjunction with the contrails in order to basically look at population control and bring us down, make us sick. Real easy to bring a sick society down and very asleep, don't you think? Yes, sir.
So, the people in your power game, they're doing what they're doing. How are they protecting themselves?
The question was how do the people in the power game protecting themselves? I sat in with the governor of Colorado one day at lunch, Dick Lamb. And Dick and I were discussing some other things, and he mentioned that he was happy because he had done his job and he got his ticket. Now he's finishing up his tour as the governor of Colorado. And I said, what ticket? And he said, well, I got my ticket. And then he explained to me there is a underground facility in Australia called Pine Gap that the Rockefellers built for 35,000, a quote, chosen people. He got his ticket. I didn't get mine. See, I was a little upset. So they think they're going to be out of harm's way. Now, I look things at kind of crazy. This week has been, once you read these books a couple of times, I want you to look at the big game. If you were at the top of one of the Committee of 300 companies, and I'm going to name one, Boeing, and you knew that there's going to be something major in Seattle, and you got a bunch of executives, what would you do?
Get out of Dodge.
Oh, really? What's going on with Boeing?
They're getting out of Dodge.
I'm sitting here, it's the first thing that I said. What's going on? Then I find out the head of Starbucks is leaving. What party's going on? The head of Amazon's going, right? They're moving everything down to Kentucky. Did you know that?
No.
Oh, things are happening. And it's right in your papers. See what I look at different than you might? You see, I'm looking with the players. The guys inside, they have a presentation that you do out in front of the public. We're nice guys. We're going to do this for you. We're going to take this for you because you're not smart enough to do it yourself, right? But if you're my buddy in behind the scenes, hey, something's going to happen. Now, they've already said that they're going to be moved by what? The end of the year?
Mm-hmm.
Somebody asked me about timing. What do you guys think is going to happen? Now, watch the Middle East. You hear anything about Arafat right now? Have you heard anything?
No.
What's going on over there? Arafat and his whole group, and Israel's all up in the air because they're having, people are dying every day. You don't hear it in the paper right now, but lots of them. So you know that's the point that they're going to start it in the Middle East because the plan was to get a war started in the Middle East. Isn't that what it says in the Bible?
Yeah.
We've got to follow the game. We wrote the play, so you guys follow right in. So you want to get in the observer node of the big picture. How do you get in the observer mode? Read those three books about three times. Get the genius frequency so we can change the ending of the story. Seriously. Because since thought created all this, and we are all part of the creation's thought, and it's out of balance, we may, timing-wise, by the year 2012, which is the next 12 years, if you haven't got it turned around, we don't have a planet left. We're going to be just like Mars. You're going to see a lot more pictures of ETs and a lot more spacecraft and everything, because there is a government plan to unite the entire planet, against the common enemy, and that's the ETs. The guys that could help us, they want them to fight away, because evil can only control this dimension, the third dimension. Think about it. And they only want to control a smaller amount because they can't take care of it. The more education we get, the internet's a real bane to them, because a lot of knowledge is going out there to a lot of people. Okay, open. Yes, sir.
Did we actually go to the moon?
The question was, did we actually go to the moon? No. When I in my office, I'm sitting here talking on the phone to the guy with the video thing in NASA's headquarters in Houston. He says, George, watch what I'm putting into the screen. And you saw it on the TV. Now, I've had this verified by a lot of other people, and we have a videotape, and I have a few of them back here. It says NASA mooned America. Let me give you some funny things, because I couldn't believe how much we had. They said the bigger lie, the bigger it is to get to the people. And why did they put up this big facade? It's kind of like Kennedy getting killing. If you want to know that, I'll tell you what happened. Anyway, I'm sitting here talking.